there. Today we are talking all about why and how we do memory work in our morning basket.
This is Your Morning Basket, where we help you bring truth, goodness, and beauty to your homeschool day.
I am Pam Barnhill, and I want to welcome you to my YouTube channel. Now, if you are interested in homeschooling and morning time and combining your kids to make your life much easier, then hit the subscribe button or the little bell to be notified whenever we have a new video. Okay, so today we are talking all about memory work in your homeschool and why you would want to do it and how we do it, though our way is not the only way, as always. But I just want to give you a few ideas of how we do memory work. Okay, so let's start a little bit with the why we do memory work in our homeschool. And the first reason I'm going to give you is because it is a lot of fun. We really, really enjoy doing memory work. Of all the things that I pull out in my homeschool, I have never heard groans about memory work. They just do it. And they absolutely love it. So it's a lot of fun. I enjoy it. I feel like it's good for my brain, which leads me to number two. I feel like memory work keeps the brain active. It's a nice challenge for the brain. You're doing some very important kind of brain calisthenics when you're doing memory work. And I feel like it's helped me over the years to just have a better memory. The third thing is, when you are memorizing quality material, things like poems and scripture and passages and speeches and things of that nature, then you are storing in your heart some important words, and you are never going to be alone. My mentor, Cindy Rollins, said, if you have a poem with you, you're never alone. Even, you know, if you're imprisoned one day, if you are at the ends of the earth, you're never alone because you have those words in your heart. Even if you don't have a book to read, you have stored those words and can pull them up and recite them. And that is such a wonderful thing. Now, and the final thing about memory work is it can be a really helpful tool. We have memorized skip counting to go along with our multiplication facts. So we sing these little skip counting songs, and my kids have used those to help them with their multiplication facts. And actually the other day, my daughter said their math tutor commented on how much those skip counting songs helped them with their math. It just makes math so much easier for them because they know those multiplication facts. And so, you know, it can really be a helpful resource in your homeschool. Now, the last thing I'm going to say is there is a fabulous talk out there by Andrew Pudua, and I'm going to be talking more about Andrew in just a minute, but his talk is Nurturing Competent Communicators, and this talk has probably had one of the biggest influences on my homeschool of anything else that I have ever heard or read or anything. And one of the things Andrew talks about in there is building reliable linguistic patterns. And one of the ways that you can do this, there are two ways. One way is reading aloud, and we do a lot of that in our morning basket, but the other way is through memorization. And this is one of the reasons that talk was very convicting to me. You can find it at no charge on the IEW website. I'll put a link below. And it's just made the biggest difference in our homeschool. So we're trying to build those sophisticated language patterns by memorizing. That's another one of the reasons we memorize. And then in turn, it helps to turn my kids into better speakers and into better writers and help them to have a better vocabulary. And let me tell you, it's a much more fun way to do that than like filling out a vocabulary workbook or something like that. Okay, so now that I've talked a little bit about why we memorize, I want to show you how we memorize. And it occurred to me as I was getting ready to make this video that how we memorized has really changed some as my kids have gotten older. So I'm going to make another video in the next week or so where I talk about some of the memory work techniques we used when my kids were younger, because they were different And I think they were really helpful. We played a lot of fun games and did some things like that. And so I want to kind of break down some of those fun ways that we used to do memory work. Now that my kids are older, we just go to the most basic, simple way to do memory work, and we recite it together. They just do it now. I don't have to make it quite as fun or exciting or interesting with all the little fun techniques. And we just sit and do it together every day, which takes a lot of pressure off of me, but I will be back with some of those fun techniques. So the heart of our memory work program comes from this IEW product called Linguistic Development Through Poetry Memorization. So we started using this years ago. Then we took a break for a while in order to do some different memory work. And then we came back to it about a year ago. And so this is something that we really enjoy. This is something that we have a lot of fun with. And what it is is 5 levels of about 19 poems in each level. And you start at the very beginning and you memorize through all 5 levels. Now, are we going to get through all 5 levels before my kids graduate? Probably not, because we took that break. Am I okay with that? I am perfectly okay with that. You know, homeschooling is a marathon and we are not in a race with anybody but ourselves. So we are just going to keep going. Now, one of the things I love about this particular resource is that the poems are absolutely delightful. And somebody has asked me before, well, couldn't I just go and pick out my own poems? Yeah, you sure could, but sometimes I have a little more money than I do time, and it's just easier for me to go with the resource where the poems are already chosen for me, and they are so delightful. So it starts off with very short poems at the very beginning, and they're fun poems that kids really, really love. And so that was one of the things that was really appealing about the program, is that you did have those really short, fun poems to start with. Now, they fairly quickly get into longer selections, but the joy of those early selections and the fun of those early selections don't change. And so kids have a lot of fun reciting those particular poems. So it comes with the teacher's guide, and in the teacher's guide there are instructions how you can go and download the student pages to go with the teacher's guide as well. And you're going to hear in a few minutes why we don't really use those, but you could download them and print them, and they make great pages for your kids to look at. And also there are some wonderful pictures on there that they can color. Now the product itself also comes with this nice little binder of CDs, and on the CDs Andrew Pudua reads the poems. So you could actually put these in your CD player in your car or something like that and listen to the poems and recite along with Andrew. We have not done that either, and I'm about to show you why. So this is just a fabulous product. We absolutely love it. It's probably one of the highlights of our homeschool, and if I lost it, I would go back and buy it again. That's how much I just absolutely enjoy. And the pieces get longer, and the pieces get more difficult, and the pieces age up and grow with your kids. One of the other things about this product is it is actually based on the Suzuki method. So Andrew Pudua is a Suzuki trained violin teacher. So basically in the Suzuki method, you add to your repertoire by doing one piece, you learn that piece, and then you learn a second piece, and you do every piece every day. And that's how it is with this poetry method. By the time you get to the end of a level, you are reciting 19 poems every single day. It really doesn't take that long. It only takes us about 10 to 11 minutes to do. And so it's a fairly small chunk of our day. But then when you move to level 2,
you start reciting all of the level two poems, every poem every day, and then you go back and you're doing level one poems, every poem every other day. And the really cool thing about the teacher's guide here is they lay it all out for you and tell you, like, there's a sheet in here that tells you which poems to memorize, which, you know, as you're working through a level, and then what your review poems are. So they've completely laid it all out for you. And that's a fabulous thing about this program. Okay, so let me show you kind of our modified version of the program, because I will say, over the years, we have added other memory work into what we're doing. So for a while, we took a break from this program and we did things like the math facts and other things. But since we've come back to the program, there have still been other things that we have wanted to add to our memorization. So this is the memorization section of my binder, and it's really hard to see because there's a glare here. And you can see this is the level one page of the linguistic development through poetry memorization. And I've got the student pages in here, just kind of printed off and put in my binder in page protectors. This was one of the things, at first I wasn't using page protectors years ago, and I very quickly realized that I needed to add page protectors because these pages were getting a lot of handling. Now, you're gonna see that we also have some additional pieces of memory work. So this is a piece that I actually printed off from simplyconvivial.com. It is from The Tempest, which was a Shakespeare play that we did last year, and I wanted my kids to memorize a few different passages from The Tempest. And so I actually have put those passages in here, and they are in our memory work rotation. This one actually comes from Ken Ludwig's website, How to Teach Your Children Shakespeare, which is another fabulous memory work resource that I highly recommend. I had Ken Ludwig on the podcast talking about memorizing Shakespeare, and I can link that one for you as well. So I've inserted in between my IEW memory work some other pieces that I've wanted to memorize. This particular piece is Nothing Gold Can Stay, and this piece comes from my own Morning Time subscription. We have things that we memorize in there, and sometimes I want to memorize those pieces, and so I print them out and put them in my binder. So you can see I have a nice hodgepodge of memory work pieces that I have added to the IEW memory work program. So this goes back to using the curriculum as a tool and not a master. This means we're going to move slower through the IEW memory work program. This means that some things about, you know, our patterns are gonna change, and I might not be able to use their handy review sheets, but that's okay because we are memorizing some things that we absolutely love. I've also got Psalm 100 in here and just various things that we're doing. Now, because we have added some pieces, we have gone ahead and switched to, you can see, it's hard to, whoop, you can see there's some little red marks here. We have already gone and switched to every other poem, you know, and changing up the frequency. We don't now do every single one of these poems every day because our morning time memory work session was getting longer and longer. Okay, so I have all of my memory work in my binder, and right now with my kids ages 10, 13, and 15, when it's time to do memory work, I simply open the binder up and we start working through at the beginning, alternating between the poems. And then when we get into the last probably five poems, we recite all five of those. So the five that we've most recently learned, we recite all five of those. But the earlier poems, we do every other one, depending on what day it is. And we just alternate. If today it's the odds, tomorrow it's the evens. And we just go back and forth like that. And quite simply, I just read the poem out loud and then my kids say the poem with me. Now, they don't have a copy of the poem in front of them. You might have some kids who would prefer that, and that's where those IEW printable student pages come in. You could print them for those particular students. It's just never been a thing for us. We've never done it that way. I have always been the only one with the book, and I have recited the poems, and they just listen to it, and when they can recite it with me, they do. Now, another reason to print out the poems, though, I do want to say this. My friend Misty Winkler, when she was doing morning time with little kids and older kids, she had some kids who were 11 or 12, and then she had some toddlers. And every once in a while, she would have to get up and leave the room to take care of those toddlers or even those infants. So she made all of her kids a copy of the memory work, and they all had their own binder. And when she had to get up and leave the room with the toddler, her older kids knew they did not stop the memory work. They kept reading and reciting, and because they had it there in front of them, they were able to do that. And so that is another kind of argument for having memory work binders for your kids. Now, my friend Heather Tully uses the memory work binder as a rite of passage. So once her kids get to, I think it's like second grade, then they finally get their own memory work binder. Heather has 10 kids, and it's a really big deal for those little ones to finally reach that rite of passage and get their own memory work binder. So there are some arguments for having the kids each have their own binder. It's just not the way we've ever done it. So there's no right or wrong way in doing this. Now, when we get to a new poem that the kids absolutely don't know, it's okay. I just read the first part of the poem and, read it to them, and they listen to it. And they may do that for a couple of days, and then usually on the third or fourth day, they are joining in. We also break those poems down. So when we start learning a new poem, if it's five or six stanzas long, I don't read all five or six stanzas. If they don't know what if they don't have it memorized, I just read the first stanza. And then once they're able to start joining in on that first stanza, after a few days, then I add the second stanza. And we do just the first two for 4 or 5 days. And then once they're able to join in for most of that, then I do the next one. So that's how we kind of handle that situation. I will say my kids know these things much better than I do. So recently, I've started handing off the binder to the other kids to give my mind a little bit of extra work in really remembering what the poems and the passages are and not just reading what's on the page. And the kids laugh at me quite a bit because I don't always get it right if I'm not reading the book. And so it's really good when your kids get older to let them hold the book sometimes and you not look at it. Which begs the question, if the kids always have a copy of the poems in front of them, are they memorizing as quickly and as well? So you might want to occasionally have them close the book and if they have one and not look at it while they memorize. Now, I do want to say this is not a test. This is something that my family does together. And a lot of times when I have moms say, my kids hate memory work, this is just not something that they like to do, it's because what's been happening is the mom has been quizzing the children on whether or not they've memorized the passage. And quite frankly, the only time we ever do something like that is when my kids request it. So every once in a while, we'll be doing memory work and one of the kids will say, I want to try this one. And we just let that one kid do that particular piece of memory work. Now, if we start that one day, then typically what happens is the next kid will say, oh, I want to do the next one. And then they'll see if they can do the next one all by themselves. And we'll kind of have some days, maybe about once a month, where we go through and everybody's kind of testing themselves on whether or not they remember certain poems. But it's all done in fun, and it's not something that I require. So a lot of times when moms say their kids don't like memory work, it's because the kids feel like it's a test. You're constantly testing me on whether or not I have this memory work memorized. In our family, it's not like that. It's something we all do together, even mom. It's not like you children will memorize this while I, the mom, read the book and dictate it to you. Instead, this is something that I am doing with them, and they know that I am memorizing the passages as well, albeit never as quickly as they do. So that's kind of how we do memory work. Hopefully I've laid that out for you in a way that helps you to understand it. Now, I'll be back again, like I said, in a week or so, and share with you some of the fun games and different ideas that I've used for making memory work really interesting to little kids over the years. I think you're going to find, though, that if you try this and start with one poem, one short, fun poem with your kids is the way to start, that your kids probably will just really, really enjoy this time you're spending together, filling their hearts and their minds with wonderful, wonderful words. Okay, so tell me in the comments below whether or not you do memory work, and if you do, what is your very favorite piece that you have ever memorized? And I will look through my binder and try to choose one and put that down below for you to see as well.